Rouse. Corey Rouse, of Her Majesty's Chief Service. Today you'll find out how to become a real 00 agent in 007, Everything or Nothing.
That's right. You'll learn the best tactics for co-op mode, uncover how to earn platinum rewards, and take you through some of the hardest levels in the game.
All that and more, only on this 00 edition of Cheat. Agent Corey Rouse, and you're watching Cheat, your undercover source for strategy, secrets, and cheats for your favorite video games.
And I'm Agent Wood, Tina Wood. Here we are at Q Division's Cheat Facility. We're tackling 007, Everything or Nothing.
We'll be covering everything from Bond moments to cheats, so let's get started with the mission briefing. James Bond 007 Everything or Nothing is the latest installment of the game franchise to introduce Pierce Brosnan as everyone's favorite English spy.
Drop your weapon. Who are you?
Bond. James Bond.
Q returns to give parental advice to the juvenile agent who only has one thing on his mind.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
And you won't if I have any say in the matter.
Also lending their vocal talents to the game are Willem Dafoe.
Then we unleash our little nanobots on the world.
And Heidi Klum is Dr. Nodonova. And, of course, Jaws. Shannon Elizabeth also lends her unique talents to the game as one of the legendary Bond girls. And Maya opens up the game with her soundtrack to James Bond, rivaling even some of the classic live-action films, making Everything or Nothing the most star-studded 007 game ever made. Not your ordinary third-person shooter game, Everything or Nothing emphasizes the importance of being a real spy to uncover the secrets of the nanobots.
I'm disappointed. I thought we were going to have dinner in London.
Stealth your way through missions as you hide behind walls and crouch behind large objects to take down the enemies. And learn to use your Bond sense in crucial areas in the game to locate items to complete each objective. Begin your missions by taking part in the training exercise. Here you'll learn to fight hand-to-hand and to use the rappel gun to climb up the sides of walls. But what's a Bond game without the cool gadgets?
Pay attention, 007.
Q has invented small robotic spiders to aid you in your missions. Use them to navigate through tight crawl spaces and to destroy junction boxes that may impede your path. There's also three different types of grenades in Bond's arsenal to use in crucial situations. There's a frag grenade, strobe grenade, and the EMP grenade to take out any electrical device. Q has also updated MI6's motor pool by importing the Porsche Cayenne, Aston Martin Vanquish, and the Triumph Daytona 600 motorcycle into the game. But put both hands on the wheel because the developers have introduced a real engine under the hood. The car will slide and turn like a real car, so watch out for pedestrians and trees. Precision driving is a must in this game, but remember, you always have rockets to fall back on. There's also some fun Easter eggs to uncover in every level called Bond moments. These capture the action and charm of this gentleman spy's signature moments from the Bond movies. So if you see a damsel in distress, or underdressed, go say hello and get some extra points.
We've learned a few new tricks, haven't we? Could you be a dear and get me a drink, please?
James Bond, Everything or Nothing has more secrets and weapons to uncover.
Bond, my nanotech weapons destroy all metal they touch. And it appears the only weapon you have left is sarcasm.
But before Bond pulls off his best Houdini impersonation, coming up, we're answering your viewer request for 007, and we'll uncover the platinum unlockable cheats.
Goodbye, James.
Remember, what we show you is for your eyes only.
I just got... Later on the show, we're also going to show you through some of the toughest levels in Everything or Nothing and show you how to earn a platinum ranking for some key missions.
Why you got to be hateful?
I didn't think I was being hateful.
That's pretty angry.
No, I just think it was funny.
Well, it was a Bond reference. We're doing a Bond show.
I'm sorry.
You should have... Yeah. Should have got Laura. Now get over here.
She's overrated.
Well, think about what you've done. All right, now we're about to show you some of the best Bond moments in Everything or Nothing coming up right now.
Oh, nice little reference from my show.
Well, I thought.
I'm gonna go eat.
007 Everything or Nothing explodes onto your screen with all the action of a Hollywood movie. What sets James Bond apart from other spies is, when completing a mission, he does it with finesse and superior skill. These are known as Bond moments. Completing these moments will help you find hidden items, mission shortcuts, and subduing your enemies in style. Not to mention increasing your score to earn gold mission rewards. In Mission A Long Way Down, Bond must rappel down the nanotech facility. On the first level, look up to the left for a rappel point, where you'll find the Dragunov sniper rifle, completing the first Bond moment. Rappel down and go left through the tunnel. Open the steam valve to stun your enemies and make short work of them for the second moment. Rappel down to the next level, and inside, flip the table for cover and drop the enemies through the window for the third. Rappel to the third level and open another steam valve to stun your enemies for the fourth. Once you've shut off the flames, go inside and use your Bond sense to target the weak ceiling. Then shoot it down on top of your enemies for the final Bond moment. In Mission Train Chase, Bond must catch a train in his Porsche Cayenne Turbo. After the first long tunnel, look for the shortcut to the left. Follow this road and shoot down the helicopter for the first Bond moment. Ahead, as the temple collapses around you, jump the fallen columns for the second moment. Now let's catch that train. Look for a ramp between the giant foot ruins and jump the tracks for the final Bond moment. In Mission Mardi Gras Mayhem, Bond must rendezvous with NSA agent Starling in his Aston Martin V12 Vanquish. On your way to hijacking the van, turn right against these arrows and look for a shortcut ramp across the brick courtyard for the first Bond moment. Load your Vanquish in the back of the van for the second moment.
Well done.
Later, pursue the limo with this shortcut, jumping through the concrete pipe for the third. Then disable the limo using your acid slick for the final Bond moment.
It's a glove.
In Mission Pontchartrain Bridge, Bond must stop Jaws' truck on his Triumph Daytona 600. Jump the gate for the first Bond moment. Fork to the right and rocket the enemies on the front porch for the second moment. On the bridge, jump to the oncoming side over the construction ramps for the third. And finally, when the truck jackknifes, action slide underneath it for the final Bond moment. These are just a glimpse at all the Bond moments to be discovered in 007 Everything or Nothing. And the added points will help you earn gold to unlock the platinum objectives. We still got more Bond goodies than you could shake a Moonraker at.
We'll show you strategies for cooperative play and cheats you can unlock by earning platinum ratings.
And that's all coming up, only on Cheat. Come on.
Welcome back to Cheat! Agents Rouse and Wood believes that they are deep undercover to give you the goods on 007 Everything or Nothing. But they are, in fact, under my control!
Corey, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Look, there's no denying that some of the levels in the latest Bond game are hard enough to knock the living daylights out of you.
But as luck would have it, we've got the solution to one of this game's toughest levels.
No.
James Bond Everything or Nothing has incorporated all the finer points of Ian Fleming's character James Bond into an action-adventure espionage game. From the high-octane explosions to extreme car chases. And of course, what's a Bond movie without Bond women? We've received viewer requests from Hero of Winds, SpongeBoy 1985, and BonzoSo 21, who are having a hard time seeing the light in the Vertigo mission. Well, grab your GPS and night vision goggles, because Cheat's going undercover. Bond has been instructed to find 003's whereabouts on top of the mountain with the help of Serena. The first level of the mine is relatively easy. Take out the guards and rappel to the second level. More guards will impede your path, so take them out one at a time and head towards the elevator to the right after clearing the area. Listen to M as she tells you more about the mission.
Look for an old junction box.
Head up the shaft and watch out for agents who'll spring down from the top. There'll be an armor vest to the left. If you don't need it, leave it there, because you'll need it when you come back down after finishing your secondary mission. Turn around and look up, and you'll see another shaft leading up to the next phase of the mission. There'll be another armor vest waiting for you when you reach the top. Again, leave it if you don't need it. Run to the right and look out for the rocket that'll be coming straight at you. Duck and take out the sniper. Push the minecart and continue running forward. When the mine splits, look to the left and aim high to take out an agent hiding in the rafters. The mine going down to the right will lead you to another armored vest where you'll have to equip your thermovision to see in the dark. When you head up the mine, take cover because there's two snipers looking to take off your head. Take out the agents in your immediate area first and then go after the snipers last. When you enter the junction box room, you'll be told the uplink device is missing.
You must find that uplink device and install it so we can help you find 003.
Follow the tracks to go up another level to look for the missing uplink device. The enemies have gotten smarter at this point because now they're wearing flak jackets. They're heavily armored, so aim for their heads or fight them hand-to-hand for the quickest results. When you reach the next level, shoot the guard in the middle first because he'll turn his table over for cover. Once you dispatch the agents in the room, use the armor vest to the right and take the uplink device. Head back down to the machine room to reconnect the uplink device, and then take out the power antenna. Go back down to activate the shaft elevator where you first talked to M, but watch your back, because your area has been compromised and agents will be gunning for you. Mission complete.
Upward and onward, 007.
The elevator will now take you to the top of the mountain and on to your next assignment.
Welcome back.
Our thanks to Hero of Winds, SpongeBoy 1985, and Bonzo So 21 for the request. Stay tuned as we give you more strategies to stealth your way through everything or nothing, and send us an email to cheat@g4tv.com to let us know who your favorite Bond girl of all time is.
Careful when I want to kill.
You know, with a partner helping you out, you'll have a better chance to die another day.
It's true, but even with two 00 agents, your mission doesn't get any easier. Here are a few tactics to help you in this co-op obstacle.
Bond games have the added bonus of multiplayer options, where spies can team up and work together in cooperation mode. In Everything or Nothing, the co-op storylines actually revolve around the single-player missions, but this time you're MI6 agents investigating nanotechnology production sites. Cheat viewer the end game over and his fellow spy friend are having trouble with the last chapter of the Tunisia mission called Last Stand. Here you'll have to find and dispatch M. Safo. The first two guards Safo leaves behind are easily defeated with a few punches. At the hallway exit, take out a sniper hiding on the balcony. Now you can both run through the courtyard, clearing the area of ground soldiers while avoiding the rocket launcher fire from the balcony on the other end. With this area cleared, you can move to the next compound behind the double door switch. One agent should run to the right and take out the soldier with the rocket launcher while your partner handles the remaining soldiers. Next, you should go down the stairs in the center of the compound where there are two guards and another double switch door. Once you enter into this new room, split up. One agent going right and the other left. Stick to the walls as you fire on the soldiers in your way. These soldiers are pretty easy to take down. Just keep moving fast. You'll have a few more soldiers to rush past when you get to this doorway through the next room. Move down this walkway until you find a stairway. Go up the stairs and watch out for two guards. At the top of the stairs, you'll be back at the courtyard where you first started. There's a big gun on the upper level. One agent can man the gun and fire at the soldiers with rocket launchers in the far balconies while your partner runs below and attacks the enemies on the ground. He should aim for the far right corner of the courtyard, taking cover behind trees and firing on all the enemy soldiers he can. You don't want to use up all your ammo in the big gun, so both agents should fight together down in the courtyard until Safo makes his appearance with a big gun of his own. The best way to defeat Safo is for one agent to draw his fire on the ground level while the other attacks with the big gun on top. As long as you can continuously fire on Safo and avoid his attacks, you'll be the winning team.
Congratulations, agents. Don't get too confident, though.
Thanks to the end game over for his request. If you need any more co-op help, just send an email to cheat@g4tv.com and you'll get all the details on how to be the perfect MI6 agent.
Forget the golden gun and Everything or Nothing. It's all about the platinum. We're gonna show you how to get platinum rewards for some key missions.
But first, it's a cheat popularity poll. This week's cheat popularity poll takes spies back to the days of GoldenEye 007 for the Nintendo 64. Once gamers completed the missions 1 through 9 on 00 Agent Mode, they could access all the cheat codes when they replayed the game. There was the All Guns code to unlock every weapon. You could be an invincible Bond and fly through the game without a scratch. Or be invisible where the enemies won't see you even when you're standing right in front of them. Attack with paintball bullets in paintball mode. Or check out line mode for sketch-like graphics. Next up is the Golden Gun, where one shot takes down any enemy, or you can just give all the bad guys a big head in DK mode. Secret agents put down their controllers long enough to cast their votes for their favorite code, and the winning super spy code is All Guns. At the cheat menu on the D-pad, enter down, left, C-stick up, D-pad right, left trigger plus D-pad down, left trigger plus D-pad left, left trigger plus D-pad up, C-stick left, D-pad left, and C-stick down. Holding it down until you hear a quick chime as a confirmation. Now exit out of the cheat menu, then go back to see all guns appear. Turn all guns on and play through the mission again with every weapon in the game. For all the GoldenEye codes and more spy gadgets, check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4tv.com/cheat and cast your vote in the next Cheat Popularity Poll. I'm Corey Rouse, and I'm shaken, not stirred, thanks to cheating.
And I'm Tina Wood. I get to host with Corey Rouse, thanks to cheating.
Welcome back to Cheat. We're infiltrating the world of everything or nothing to bring you an insider's guide to 007.
That's right, Corey, but sometimes the world is just not enough, and what people really want is platinum. But only the best of the best get platinum rewards.
But even 00 agents need help from time to time. An MI6 agent's success is usually determined on whether they survive the mission. In 007 Everything or Nothing, when you complete a mission, you'll earn gold and platinum rewards for achieving specific objectives. Earn gold on the 00 agent skill level to unlock the platinum mission objectives. Earning platinum is the ultimate test of skill. Objectives vary from mission to mission, but the platinum meter will indicate your progress as we lead you through some tougher platinums. In Mission An Old Friend, Bond must sneak through an enemy train without alerting the guards. To earn the platinum, you must complete the mission without taking any damage, and stealth attacks are the key. Avoid their line of sight and quickly stealth attack the first two guards, then hide and stealth the third. Remember to destroy all the computers before you move on. In the second car, stealth the first guard and take cover to shoot the two patrolling guards. In the third car, rush the first guard right away. Then hide and wait for the second one to turn his back before attacking. In the fourth car, stealth attack the first two guards and shoot the last guard. Switch on your thermovision and immediately shoot the first guard in the fifth car. Take cover behind the barrel and pick off the guards till the car is clear to earn the platinum reward. But you still have to defeat Jaws afterwards to complete the mission. And finally, in Mission Serena St. Germain, Bond must rendezvous with a geologist.
It's Bond!
To earn the platinum, you must escape the patrols and race from the hotel to the base of the fortress in less than a minute, 55 seconds. That's barely enough time to make the drive, even if you weren't being slowed down by the missile launching patrols blocking your path. Switch on your Q cloak and immediately turn right for a shortcut to the winding road.
He controls everything.
Conserve your cloak as much as possible while still avoiding the patrols. Make a break straight through the Fountain Plaza until your battery runs out. Turn left here through the sunken alley to avoid the roadblock. Turn left to avoid the tank and skip the cinematic at the bottom of the hill. Jump off the cliff and off-road your way back up the hill. Turn left again and race through the barriers in the nick of time for the platinum reward. There are 27 platinum rewards to earn, and platinums are the key to unlocking cheats for 007 Everything or Nothing. So what are you going to do with all that platinum? Are you going to buy diamonds that are forever? Are you going to license to kill? No! You're going to get a bunch of cheat codes! You take a look at these rewards. When you're James Bond, you get gadgets and gizmos aplenty. Even if Q complains about them coming back damaged. You're suave, have style, and you're a real ladies' man. You're not afraid to go above and beyond the call of duty to get the job done. And when you have cheat codes, the job is even easier. All the codes in this game have to be earned the old-fashioned gamer way. They're unlockable features, and by being the best spy you could be and earning platinum ratings, you'll have all these goodies in no time. When you're at the Mission Select screen, you can go to the Unlock menu option. Here you'll find gadgets, rewards, and cheats as options. The rewards section features production stills that are earned with gold ratings and unlockable characters for multiplayer mode. When you've earned 27 gold ratings, you'll also unlock the gallery. Here you can run around and explore a museum with concept artwork, props, and gadgets. You can even get a close-up look at all the Bond girls in the game. Under cheats, you'll find 13 cheat codes that can be used anytime during the game once you've gotten them unlocked with enough platinum ratings. But you can't use any cheat codes to earn higher ratings and unlock the next level. It's just not allowed when you're a proper spy like Bond. You'll get the golden gun as soon as you earn the first platinum rating. Just pause the game and enter circle, triangle, X, circle, triangle. You'll hear a low chime as a confirmation if you've entered the code correctly. Now with just one shot with this gun, enemies won't get back up. You can have all the weapons when you've got 17 platinum ratings. Just enter circle, triangle, X, X, circle while at the pause screen. Now your arsenal is well stocked and Bond is ready for any situation. You can have your new weapons cause double damage when you pause the game and enter circle, triangle, triangle, square, circle. For unlimited ammo, just enter circle, X, square, X, circle. The ultimate prize after you've earned 27 platinum ratings is the platinum gun. This weapon packs an explosive bang when you enter circle, square, square, circle, X. The bad guys won't be able to escape this gunfire. If the driving levels are giving you trouble, you can give your car improved traction after earning 3 platinums when you enter circle, X, X, square, triangle. To permanently cloak your car, earn 13 platinums and enter circle, triangle, X, triangle, square. An invisible car is a must-have for any spy. To have all the codes, be sure to earn every platinum rating you can. And use all your gadgets to visit the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4tv.com/cheat, where you'll find a cheat code recap. We've got what it takes to make you as good a spy as James Bond.
Nice prize.
All right, that's it for this edition of Cheat. Remember, if you have any questions, you can check out the Cheat Sheet Master Database at g4techtv.com/cheat.
That's right, and while you're there, hit the message board or send an email to cheat at g4tv.com where you can request a code or walkthrough for your favorite game.
Let's go. Our thanks to Agent Wood for helping us out for today's show. Remember, this is Corey Rouse saying, if life's got you down, throw into God mode and keep kicking butt. We'll see you next time on Cheat. Okay, go!
Talking about.
Every weeknight while you watch X-Play and Unscrewed with Martin Sargent, go online and play Hyperactive along with the shows. You can win an iPod Mini and other cool stuff. Go to g4techtv.com/hyperactive and play along every weeknight at 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific.